Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. We just watched the first game of the first match of the night, Aware versus XGN. I am joined by Ravage, my co-caster tonight. Ravage, how you doing?
Oh, pretty good, man. Feeling good after that last match.
Yeah, so, what are you thinking after that last match?
I think Aware knows that they can compete with these guys, and I think they know that they need to get smarter in their picks and bans.
Yeah, so, and Aware and XGN, two teams that are definitely not in the top six as locks. Definitely not as locks. XGN kind of being the wild card here.
I don't know if I'd call them the wild card so much as they are the, you know, the behemoth that's dressed in sheep's clothing.
Yeah, right? I mean, they kind of came out of nowhere. Originally, they were a squad that was going through roster changes, all Xbox players. Then they played that first game, didn't do so great, and decided to just kind of, all the people on that original squad decided they're going to come back to competitive later. Denial gets picked up, and now we weren't sure if Denial was going to be able to perform on Xbox, but look at how they played just now.
I mean, I don't know. I think Denial felt really confident in their abilities, okay? I really do. I think they felt confident in their abilities. I think a lot of people were questioning if they could compete on Xbox through the controller, and a lot of people were saying, hey, don't think you can just come in here and steamroll this thing.
Yeah, yeah. And they came in and pretty convincingly showed that a lot of their skill is going to carry over. And we're jumping into picks and bans right now for the second game of this match. Candyman is banning first.
Oh, yeah, we're going to ban Hell. Yeah. They learned their lesson.
Yeah, you kind of have to ban Hell. You really do. We see in pretty much every match, Hell and Sun Wukong ban. And when we don't see Hell banned, look what happened.
Yeah, they learned their lesson. They did. I'll give them that. We should see maybe an X-Ball ban coming out on the side of XGN, or they're going to try and pick it after the fact. No, we're going to see Athena come out once again, which has been a strong pick on Xbox, but it's really faded off in light of Capri. They may try and grab that once again. That was strong for them, saved them a lot of deaths.
Yeah, a lot of the Athena bans that we've seen too, I feel like they were based around that Athena Medusa Wombo combo that everyone said was so great on the Xbox, but no one's actually played it yet. We haven't seen anyone in our league play it. So it's to be seen. Okay, we're actually going to see an Isis ban here too, and I'm assuming that is a respect ban against Mace to the Face.
It is, and not to mention the fact that we're talking about healing meta again. Isis ult. Traditional. Yeah. Can just blast a team to full health in the middle of a team fight, plus damage to the enemy team, plus protections. Big ultimate. Big team fight ultimate, especially against a team fight team like you saw that the former Denial roster is. Poseidon also coming out there, Rich.
Oh, and that Poseidon's going to leave Sun Wukong open, and we are going to see Aware jump at the chance to get Sun Wukong. That's scary.
Yeah, that's scary. Bluestone, Sun Wukong, obviously not something you want to trifle with. He's going to be very tough for anyone that you try to pick there. Some people can go toe-to-toe with him, but there's no one that really beats Sun Wukong in lane right now, just due to his strong, strong kit base with the Bluestone.
Who do you put in lane to try to contest the Sun Wukong, though? Because that's probably going to have to be their first pick.
You're going to see Hades. Hades is one pick you can put there. It's usually a stalemate lane. It's a little bit in favor of Sun Wukong now with the Bluestone, just because he's able to bully Hades nice and early. But Hades has the wave clear and the ability to sustain waves, which if you don't use your death from below to clear waves and use the silence to get the blight on them, then clear it out with your B or your 3 for those PC players, that you can actually go toe-to-toe with Sun Wukong. The problem is that you're never going to kill him because of his ultimate. It gives him CC immunity. He pops up into the air on his cloud, and that's it.
So we're actually going to see right now where Gaming's going to lock in the Shiva Lanka and the Guan Yu. We mentioned that we might see a ban, XGN actually banning out Shiva Lanka. They didn't, and we are going to see where punish that. Guan Yu, though, I'm wondering if they are picking the Guan Yu to try to keep healing away from XGN.
That's another counter pick. That's going to be a Guan Yu jungle or support. It could go either way. We've seen him play in both roles, but I reckon that's most likely a Guan Yu jungle. Has some nice clear and the ability to at least box on mid camps and be able to zone out the enemy team. So that could be a secure pick. We're going to see global pressure, however, coming out with Mace of the Face on the Yannis.
And he is so nasty on that god. I would say Isis might be his best god, but definitely Yannis is a close second.
Yannis is definitely one of the strongest picks right now in the mid lane. His damage, just his ability scaling. Every time he uses that portal, and then with the threshold as well, The magic scaling compounds. Every time he goes through a portal, he gets magic scaling. Every time someone runs over his threshold, magic scaling as well. So what you end up happening is once you do that, the Giannis ultimate can almost one-shot people at late game, especially like a Freya, you know, a Freya or an X-Ball.
Yeah. The comp is looking strong for both teams, though, right now. Who do you think we could see being banned next? We are going to see...
You're going to see an AD champion banned out because they're heavy on the magic side, on the side of XGN, and if they don't... They don't want to get countered out hard, an itemization. They're going to have to pick two. They're going to have to pick an AD jungle and AD soul. No doubt.
And right now we are going to see Homie actually take his pick. It showed up for a second, then it went away really quick. I'm curious to see, though. It's definitely not an easy call. Not an easy call at all.
The Zeus is going to be banned out. Smart ban, as that was troublesome. He did top the damage charts at the end of that game next to the X-Ball. He was number two on the list. So a good ban on the side of XGN. Odin is an interesting ban, probably for the X-Ball and the Guan Yu. They don't really have a good escape over the Ring of Spears.
Oh, Bastet. That is a reasonable pick.
That could be solo lane or jungle. Bastet solo right now has crept its way into the meta.
What do you think of it solo, though, against Sun Wukong? Sun Wukong, Bastet? You don't think Sun Wukong just steamrolls the Bastet?
Bastet can jump over the cudgel, right? So that's the strength there. She can pounce and then pounce back. Pounce over, do damage, get the bleed on, pounce back. So early game with the cats, if she can get the level 5 first with those cats, she may be able to actually win the matchup. It's still going to be really hard.
Yeah, Bastet, so strong at level 5. Absolutely. Those cats are almost a guaranteed kill. Might see a Hades here.
That's a Hades mid right there.
Yeah, that's... It's a pretty strong pick. And the Ares.
Yeah, that's an anti-tank pick right there. They know that there's going to be another tank picked up here with the Kepri, and they don't want to get into that situation where they want the lockdown, okay? Ares is going to be able to do percentage health damage, and we're going to see Nemesis right there to counter the counter-tank little comp that that Aware was going with here. You're going to see the Guan Yu shreds protections. Ares shreds through percentage health, and then you have the Hades with the Pillar of Agony as well. That was, if they went with the Nemesis, that would have been a real strong pick, but they're going to opt to go with Xing Chen.
Yeah, they're moving all around. They still haven't locked in yet. They could still end up falling back on the Nemesis. They've been moving around between Osiris, Xing Chen, and Nemesis. What do you think? Oh, they're going to lock in with the Osiris at the end of the day. What do you think of that pick?
The Osiris is for the ultimate.
It's for the ultimate? For the team fights?
Yeah, healing reduction on the ultimate for the Guan Yu and the Hades is what that's all about there, as well as the Sun Wukong. So it's a sensible pick.
Yeah, so actually looking at these two comps, it looks like I might favor Aware in the laning phase and in team fights.
It's going to be actually tough for Hades to move in on the wave. He can't clear with his death from below, okay? And it's going to be hard for him to zone up on in the wave to get a silence off because Giannis's unstable vortex could hit Yubs every time, and it could eventually poke him down. He does have the sustain, but he doesn't have the benefit of the blue buff like the solo lane. So the other thing is, if you death below into the wave as Hades, Giannis can put a portal down right on top of you, right? And then you can drop down and take even more damage, plus the CC.
That could be very strong. I'm curious to see, last game, as far as we talked about the comps quite a bit, but how do you think individual player-wise and team-wise, did any team outclass the other team? Do you think that XGN actually outclassed Aware, or do you think it all came down to just being thrown off guard by this healing team that XGN put together?
That was picks and bans. That was all picks and bans. Aware showed that they can compete with XGN nice and early. They showed they can compete with an SPL team, and they did it well until the picks and bans actually played against them. I mean, you're going against a top-level team here. These guys were in the SPL. You just don't get through the SPL as a joke team or a challenger team. You don't get there. These are all well-known players, right? And to be able to come out there and get those early kills they did, Aware has to feel confident that they can come in here and they can win this game if they picked and banned right. And I think in this situation, I think they have a nice pick and bans.
Yeah, I think they have a very good chance here to split the match. Just Hades, Ares, Guan Yu, Shiva Lanka, and Sun Wukong. That's a scary list of characters. That is very, very scary. I'm trying to actually see how XGN can play in a team fight right now. I'm trying to see where the Freya fits in with the Kepri, the Jaunus, the Bastet, and the Osiris.
Okay, the nice thing about the Freya and the Jaunus is that when the Ares ults in lane, they're going to be nice and safe on the Freya. And when he rotates to mid lane, if he tries to blink ult to top of the Jaunus has CC immunity. So,
oh, okay.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how that works out. I think the Ares in this point was more taken as at least an ult or a beads popper and probably for the percentage health damage on the Kepri.
Yeah, just kind of get in there, put the pressure on, get rid of the beads, and then let the squad roll through and just take advantage of the fact that you can't get away from any of their CC.
Yeah, the issue is that if you ult out of the Ares ultimate, Hades could come in with the Pillar Agni from a side lane and lock you down, as well as the Guan Yu with his horse could come in as well with a CC on that, with the stun, come down and lock you into the Pillar of Agni and get you into a situation where there's a lot of damage going down. Not to mention with Sun Wukong, there's a lot of lockdown there as well in his Tiger form, as well as damage with the Cudgel and his ultimate. There's a lot of damage that people don't seem to realize in that as well as a huge gap closer.
And the more I am looking at this Aware comp, the more confident I am in their pick spans. It's looking good.
But rotations will be on the side of XGN. They have Jaunus for the mobility. They have Bastet very mobile with the pounce, able to get in and out really quick. So, yeah.
Yeah, there will never be a team fight that Mace to the Face will not be able to get to. And like you said, Bastet also having an insane amount of mobility. I think one of the best chances they have really is that Bastet kind of getting to level 5 first and winning the lane against Sun Wukong and allowing something like that to snowball.
Yeah, they definitely don't want to see the Bastet snowball here. I mean, Bastet can easily top the player damage right now. I don't think a lot of people realize that. And she can build herself in a way and do that where she's actually has the Mail of Renewal and Spirit Roll built into her build, which give her a lot of CC. Cooldown reduction, right? A lot of CR. So with that being said, Jotun's Wrath, Mail of Renewal, she builds into. She's able to sustain in and out of team fights. You know, she doesn't have a built-in heal, but she becomes the ability where she's able to get in, burst someone down, Mail of Renewal proc, get back in again to the fight.
Yeah, and also another thing with Bastet is Bastet's just such an incredible split pusher. How important do you think something like that in your kit could be in a matchup like this?
It could be really important. But the thing is, the way the builds of Bastet are going right now, they aren't being favored heavily into that split push comp that you've seen before with like the Crusher, Titansbane, and the Jotuns. You're seeing her more hybrid, like tank slash, you know, she's able to just get in there, burst down, get out.
Yeah.
Just a high mobility type of character that's able to get in and get the picks.
Yeah,
a tank killer early too. Bastet shreds tanks at level 5.
Yeah, just because of those cats, they are so powerful. They just shred right through. We did see a little bit of the split push Bastet by a few of these teams at MLG Worlds in NOLA. But like you said, it's almost like the meta is still in flux right now for this Xbox League.
The meta is in flux. You're basically a patch behind the PC, so you're seeing some new influences from current patches on PC, as well as the past influence from the forum patches, as we're just getting into some of these metas. You know, there's some buffs, debuffs, and key champions in this patch as well on the Soul patch. So,
yeah, that is the interesting thing about the Xbox. They don't necessarily just look at what the meta was for PC and just take it on blind faith. They actually really kind of break it apart, get to put their own spin on it. And you have to think about certain things like, okay, if I'm playing on a Thor, for example, my dunk's a little bit harder to hit. Uller may be really strong, but his skill shots are incredibly hard to hit. So you are working with a little bit of a different interface when you're using the controller. So you have to adapt to that. But also, you kind of have the advantage of time. You've already seen these patches get played out. You know which patches are coming next, and you know which patches have already happened. So you can adapt to the meta in that way.
That's right, and that's one advantage that Xbox does have, is that they do have established metas that they're able to. They don't have to break the box too much. They've seen a lot of it.
Yeah. And
guys like Denial, that's one of the people they're watching for these, that we're watching for this meta.
Yes, and they definitely know it very well. And we saw that by their pick spans in the last matchup. And this time, though, it does look like they may be at a slight disadvantage, if not a big disadvantage.
It'll be interesting to see how the match sizes up here. Looking at the dual lane starts here, we're going to see the Bluestone Transcendence picked up by Cruxy again on the X-Ball. We're going to see Freya starting with Vamp Shroud and Boots, getting that little bit of mobility, obviously huge on Freya, but the built-in slow as well. And we're also going to see this big rotation for the back Harpies again from XGN as they keep draining the enemy team of XP.
Yeah, and it looks like they may move into mid lane right now. Going to hop over and see Guan Yu standing there. Bastet very close to him. Hades and Guan Yu are going to open up right now. Bastet is getting a little bit low, and Jonas is going to manage to port away, get out of the team fight, swoop back around, but it looks like they are just going to hold the lane.
Look at Blacksai right now as he's going to hit with the snare. There's a lot of damage going on top of him as Krexy moves up to put some dace down. He's going to get the double chains with the slow and the cripple, plus the extra little bit of damage and protection shred there from the Ares, just to back those guys off of him. That was a close call for Blacksai.
Yeah, and we've seen a lot of action in the duo lane already, and that just kind of comes from these gods. They can get in, they can put in pressure, and they can still manage to disengage relatively safely.
Shibalanka, solo lane.
Yeah, solo lane right now. We really favored Sun Wukong, but Osiris is holding his own right now.
He is. A lot of damage being put there. Guan Yu on the dive, or getting close to a dive. They're almost stepping in on their tower shots there. Yub's going to be able to heal up. For the Guan Yu, that's one thing we didn't talk about, is Hades has the ability to heal off wave as well as Guan Yu with the ability to heal as well.
Yeah, I'm peeking back over at the duo lane right now. We might see a little action go down. Kepri is moving up into this wave. He is going to manage to move on back though. Nothing too crazy, but I could see him initiating soon.
Yeah, we could see something here. They're just getting that wave pushed in. They're trying to lose some creeps to the tower here, and we're going to see Blacksai just move it up there, try and take some of the damage, soak some of that, but we're going to lose at least two creeps to the tower here for Cruxy again. Just seeing them out pushed, the Kepri hard to deal with the nice innate lane clear built into his kit.
Yeah, I am really surprised we haven't seen more Kepri. We haven't seen too much Kepri in our league. I know Kepri for a while on Xbox. Wasn't he banned in competitive because there was some sort of bug?
No, Kepri is just banned out because of the meta right now. Candyman taking a lot of damage from Osiris in the solo lane as well. Yeah, Kepri is banned because he's a new god, pretty much. So he's banned out from competitive play, and I think that might have been the Nola patch. I'm not 100% on that.
I remember what happened originally the Nola patch happened, and everyone was saying you couldn't play Kepri because there was some sort of problem that was causing him to actually crash the Xboxes, but they resolved it, and we ended up seeing Kepri be a legal god. Yeah, at Nola.
Okay, yeah, and the same problem happened with Sylvanas. It just seems to be, I guess, a problem with supports. Sylvanas,
right?
Pretty much unplayable for the last, I guess, like month and a half on Xbox, I think, as well.
What it actually was with Sylvanas too, you know, the little green particle effect that Sylvanas is, but that the tree's feet leave behind? That was causing like a huge memory leak apparently on Xbox. So
is that what it was? I was wondering what part of that was causing the big issue with Sylvanas. So that's crazy.
One little thing
can do that.
Yeah, one little thing just kind of spiraled the whole thing out of control and would cause the client to crash.
Look at the invasion on the blue buff here. Candyman's going to step up. He'll try and steal that with the cudgel over the wall if he can time it correctly. It's not going to happen as the flail is going to pick that one up. Look at Giannis with the rotation here. It's Guan Yu and T-Small also here as well. There's the cudgel going to go down. The Ares ultimate, they're not going to be able to get out of this one. There's the beads pop from Bastet, however.
Yeah, that is kind of what we were expecting to see happen. Like, we saw a big, big rotation there for Aware. We talked about how XGN was going to be really strong at actually rotating. And then we saw kind of Aware just have a really good coordinated assault go down, try to attempt that, invade that blue buff, but it didn't work out. They weren't able to get there quite quick enough. They didn't get to push the damage on.
Yeah, and that's unfortunate. They're going to pop the tier 1 beads on Bastet, which is huge. If they can get on her in the next engagement, maybe in mid lane, when Ares starts to make his rotations over to secure mid camps, they may be able to get her with a cripple and catch her off guard. She still has a 140 second cooldown. That's a huge cooldown at tier 1 beads, so that is worth it. They did lose the blue buff camp there.
Yeah, they did. It looks like everyone is farming up at pretty much the same exact clip, too. It looks like the farm has been pretty even. We are going to see Sun Wukong go up right now. Probably not going to dive in on the Osiris. Yeah, just kind of staying in position, making sure that he doesn't die.
Cats are going to be dropped on Blackside here now as the three-man rotation is real. Homie can pick up the kill with the lead there and the Bluestone proc.
Well, there it is.
Yeah, big, big, big rotation on the side of XGN there. That's going to be first blood.
Yeah, that first blood is definitely going to matter, too. Looking right now, gold difference and XP difference have gone to the favor of XGN. XP difference being at about 2.5k and gold difference being at about 1.6.
Yeah, this is the type of thing we saw happen last game where XGen just kind of ran off with the XP and gold lead early. They haven't taken any global objectives like the Gold Fury yet, which is interesting, Rich, or just what we've seen their strategy was last time by this point in the game. Remember, around like 6:25, they had the Gold Fury.
Yeah, we saw them absolutely just go for the Gold Fury as soon as it was reasonable. I'm wondering if the reason they haven't gone for the Gold Fury yet is because of how different their comp is this time. Last time, if they went for the Gold Fury, even if a team fight did happen, they could kind of feel it out. But I'm also, as I think back to that initial Gold Fury grab, it was kind of a Gold Fury of opportunity, right? They saw that no one was going to be able to contest it in time. So I'm wondering if anything like that happens on the map, we might actually see them go for the Gold Fury again. I don't think they're a team to force it, though.
They're effectively pushing Cruxy back to his tower fairly regularly. The issue you're going to see for the side of XGN right now is to push Cruxy back into tower to try and shut him down. What they're doing is they're putting Capri in lane, who's also leeching XP with Freya. So Ares, however, is making these big rotations, getting jungle camps to the rest of his team, not really affecting his dual lane. Look for Cruxy to be able to close the gap in experience down in the dual lane.
Yeah, Cruxy definitely looking really strong. Just talked to the control room for a brief second there. It sounds like the players might be experiencing a little bit of lag, and that's why they are going to do this pause right now. We'll see if we actually manage to get through it quickly. Not sure what's causing it, though. But looking to the future of this matchup, Cruxy may be able to really lock up this duo lane. Kepri, though, has been an absolute force and really has managed to keep everything kind of locked down in the duo lane. Looking over at the solo lane, though, Sun Wukong definitely showing why Sun Wukong is banned all of the time. But not winning out the lane per se. Would you say he's winning the lane entirely?
He's not at all. I mean, if you consider 15 gold winning the lane, yeah, he's winning it hard.
Yeah,
but,
right.
He's not really coming away with that lane at all. Osiris picked up that death toll for a little bit of sustain. And, by this point, Candyman, without his blue, you have to think that cripple him on Sun Wukong. I mean, it really takes out his lane clear. He has all those points into the cudgel right now and just draining his mana bar. He can clear waves in one hit, but it's draining his mana bar, absolutely destroying it.
Yeah, and thinking about Osiris, though, Osiris, one of the reasons Osiris hasn't been seen at all in our league is because it's hard to hit that flail. It's really hard to hit the flail on Xbox.
It's really difficult, and not only do you have to hit the flail, you have to follow that up with the sickle as well, right? For the added effect.
Yeah, correct. And so, it's just, that's not easy. That's definitely not easy to do without WASD Mals.
Yeah, it's hard. It's hard. Unless you're using a scuff control or something, that even then it's hard, but it is very scuff, difficult. That's the same reason you don't see Rama picked up as much in a lower tier play on the Xbox. It's just harder to hit those abilities and auto attacks and all that stuff. And that's why you see stuff like Haste and Vitalis built on so many Hunters.
Are you more of an Xbox player or a PC player, out of curiosity?
I'm more of an Xbox player.
Yeah, so am I. I made the jump pretty much instantly. There's something about it. It's nice. It just feels right. It feels like Smite was meant to be played on Xbox. Oh, this pause is going to get resolved just in the nick of time. We are going to see something big go down here. I have a huge feeling right now that XGN is up to something. Just seeing how they played.
I feel like what they're trying to do, they're trying to outpush the duo lane to put pressure there so they can sneak into the Gold Fury. I feel like that's what they're trying to do. They're trying to establish map pressure.
Yeah, that's kind of what we saw last time, too. It was just definitely a different strategy to make it there, but they established a lot of pressure and then would spiral that into something that was absolutely huge.
It's huge. We're actually going to see the mid-camps being traded off here. Mid-camp timers actually haven't gone out of one team's hands at this point. Last time we saw those competed over nice and early, and those being traded off. We're going to see some boxing between Cruxy and Bronx here, and Freya actually going to come out on top of that boxing match.
Yeah, and it does look like everyone's starting to group up right now. Xibalanka's going to go back. Wan Yu, though, trying to put a little bit of pressure onto Freya right now, and Xibalanka decides he's not going to go back right now. Actually going to use the ultimate. It does slow Freya down, but it doesn't look like it's going to be enough.
She's going to get the nice banish there on T-Small, which is of note. Being able to take T-Small up out of there prevents him from getting that horse and narrowing the gap. Freya actually able to keep her all. We're going to see the big rotation here from Homie and Mace, as he's going to be able to kill the cats.
Yeah, we're going to actually see them rotate in, but they might get punished for going in a little bit too soon. They did pick up one kill, but now Guan Yu is up on his horse, and he's going to manage to take down two here. Yeah, there it is. Mace to the face goes down. Yeah, that's more than a trade. Now it's 2-2. It's even on the board, and we might see Aware Gaming continue to push through. They are all in this lane right now. Osiris does look like he might be able to push that lane a little bit. Sun Wukong did have to go back there. But that fight, I kind of favor Aware in that.
Aware able to clean it up a little bit, which is good, okay? That Pillar Agni, you're going to see what I mean when I say beads popping comp. They're able to pop the CC there after Bastet picked up that kill there, pop the beads and all their escapes. And then Hades just comes in with the Pillar of Agni. He's able to secure those two guys and keep them locked down. There was a ton of damage dealt to both Capri. And it was Bastet who went down there, or was it it was Mace to the face?
It was Mace. Mace went down.
Yeah, used the ultimate to get over there with the quick transition and had no escape from the Pillar of Agni.
You're actually going to see Guan Yu there, just kind of stand there, take a few hits, let Cruxy get all the XP. Cruxy, like you said, he's kind of the player to look at, because this duo lane is going to be incredibly important, and if Cruxy can't keep up with the pressure that we are going to see XGN put on right now, this could be where it falls apart for them.
Yeah, the thing is, Cruxy's going to fall off a little bit here, as you're going to see... You're going to see Freya go back, and she's likely going to be able to pick up Haste and Vitalis here. And that's where Freya comes online. Freya really comes online in the mid game for a little bit when she gets that Haste and Vitalis. Before Cruxy's able to get Solier, she has that innate magical lifesteal as well, right? So with that being said, the Haste and Vitalis with the movement speed, the built-in slow, and the lifesteal, she'll be able to outbox Cruxy for at least the next 5 minutes of the game.
Yeah, and do you think that'll only last for the next 5 minutes, and then once Cruxy kind of picks it back up, gets some of his build online, he might actually, in the late game, be able to take Freya on?
Freya traditionally falls off for a little bit after she gets the Haste of Vitalis. After the Soul Eater comes on from the carry, it's usually when you see her fall off a little bit. You're going to see her take a lot of damage here now, going down to half health. Is the nice rotation from Blackside and Cruxy to come in from the side lane.
Yeah, we saw there a lot of good pressure onto Freya. And that's going to be big, because that's going to allow them to continue putting pressure onto that lane. And like you said, Freya right now is as dangerous as she will be for the rest of the match. She's like at a heightened level of danger. Just having all those items online, that is going to be tough for Sheba Lanka. And we actually are going to see them move in onto Sheba Lanka. They're not going to waste any time. Kepri's moving in. Mace to the face dropping his portal right now, and that might be enough to secure the kill. Bastet's going to actually pick it up.
Pop up into his ultimate, though.
Yeah, that was a really good rotation, though. We are going to see Guan Yu fill back into that lane right now with Hades as well. Too late, though.
That is an interesting rotation, as they actually undershot the Yana assault to start there, and they were actually really far behind. But Cruxy's lack of boots, as well as Ares as well, trying to just stay back appeal, inevitably ended in Ares' death there. So we saw that the gamble for Cruxy's boots really paid off for him last game. He was able to get that Soul Eater on nice and early. But this time you can see it actually cost his teammate a death. And you have to think that XGN picked up on that.
Yeah, they're definitely the type of team that's going to notice something like that. They understand this game very well. The only thing that we're really worried about with them is, can they steamroll Xbox? Can they move to Xbox incredibly fast? And we are seeing that the knowledge is going to be much more important than anything else here.
Yeah, that's the thing. You're going to see XGN actually pull apart on a lot of teams right now, as they've just been around the PC scene for so long and played at such a high level, and they've been exposed to these big events, these big lands. They know what picks and bans are all about. They know about the rotations, and they've practiced all this stuff. Not to say that Aware hasn't, but they're at this point, they have two new members to their squad. It's a little bit different here. The game knowledge hasn't transferred to Cruxy and Yubs just yet.
Yeah, Cruxy, though, has been doing an incredible job of keeping pressure on Freya and pretty much winning the lane over and over again. But they want to take Cruxy down right now, and I would not be surprised if this rotation did pay off for them. He sees it coming, though.
The issue is for Cruxy is that he's missed out on so many purple camps right now, as he's been constantly invaded, as you'll see again, is that he's actually behind on XP but ahead on gold, which is really unfortunate. We're going to see the big rotation here as Jubs makes his way in with the death from below, but not able to narrow the gap there. He's not going to be able to get the Pillar Agony down. Here's the Ares ult.
Yeah, this is definitely looking like a team fight that might go in the favor of XGN already.
the snare on T-Small. T-Small gonna have to get on his horse here. He's gonna look to focus on the Freya here, look to get the stun off, and he will. As Bruxy comes in, he may get a passive attack here on Bronx, but how long will he be able to survive? There's the big Pillar of Agony from Yubs, and Yon is so low, but he's gonna pick up the kill right before he's gonna fall to Yubs. Finally, Cruxy on the chase down on top of Kepri. Kepri just barely gonna get out of there.
Yeah, that team fight very quickly moved into favor of Aware. Why do you think that was? Do you think it was because of the initiation, or do you think it was actually just because of the comps?
It's because of counter initiation right there. You've seen that Vasta was able to drop her cats. They knew they had their beads up there, and they timed it wonderfully. They saw that Ares is going up, drop the cats. He's very immobile. He's going to get hit by those cats. He's just going to take a lot of damage. We've seen him poke down about 3 bars of health. And with that, you know, the Yannis ult comes out as well. Hits Ares as well. Ares is dropped down effectively useless out of that team fight. And they kicked him out. They come through the Yannis portals, and they're able to close the gap there. XGN almost turned that around.
Yeah, they really almost did. But now we're 13 minutes, 20 seconds into this game. Only 4 kills for XGN and 5 for Aware.
Right, it's interesting to note, gold difference is even out.
The gold difference is pretty much exactly the same. The XP difference only being, it's not even 3K. It's about 3K now. But it's swinging all over the place. It's definitely not one team's game right now. They just have to continue playing this game the right way. It's the first team that makes a big mistake that's really going to get punished.
The XP difference, this will be interesting to point out here, is actually all in Kepri.
Really?
It's all in Kepri. He has 2 levels on Ares right now.
That is absolutely huge. How do you think you play that to your advantage?
Farming rotations, Rich is what it's all about. I've seen Echoes in the chat. He'll tell us all about those support farming rotations, just able to get back on the backhand and stuff like that when they're idle.
Yeah.
Support soloing them, it can really make a difference.
Yeah, so seeing that right now, we are going to see... Wow, I'm very surprised by that. I did not notice that until you mentioned it.
Yeah, even at the builds right now, though. Especially when you're looking at your support. Here's the Eerie Salt under tower on Osiris, and he's going to get pulled in. He can go down, and Bobby going to get Tiger formed as well.
Yeah, we are going to see right now Osiris actually is going to go down.
Bronxy in a lot of trouble too here in the dual lane. He is boxing with 3 different people, body blocked at the corner of the wall. Bronxy going to pick up that kill as well as Yubs makes the rotation, but way too late.
Yeah, we're actually going to see a pause from Croxy there. What are you seeing with the builds right now? Anything really interesting coming online?
The interesting thing is that we see Hasten online finally from Freya, but Cruxy obviously ahead 400 on gold here, so he does have the Soul Eater. He started into his boots as well. So watch for him to start being able to outbox the Freya just a little bit. The other interesting thing is just look at what the Ares building. Ares building into Sovereignty or Mystic? Oh, man. Oh, I can't tell. Hades with the Warlock Sash, no stacks. So that's going to put him behind, at least for now, but as we scale the late game, it's going to make him really tanky and going to give him a lot of extra magic power.
Yeah, he's definitely in a place right now where he still can pick up the Warlock Sash. He's going to be able to get some stacks onto it pretty easily. It's still... This is around the time when you usually see Warlock Sash come online, right?
It really depends. Sometimes you don't see the Warlock Sash now until after you see your cooldown and your magic pen built. It's been kind of the standard thing. You see your cooldown, maybe like a Kronos pendant, something like that, and then maybe like a spare Magus come on, and then you see your Warlock Sash. Usually you see stacking items going on number 3 now. It's not uncommon to see Hades first build Warlock Sash, to be completely honest.
All right. So, yeah, 15 minutes into this match, we've seen a few of the team fights go down. We've seen a lot. We've seen the laning phase. Who do you think is really going to take this game?
It's hard to say at this point. I mean, there's a lot of team fight potential on both sides. You have a lot of ability to zone on the side of Aware, as we talked about in the pregame, but XGN does have a nice late game comp. I mean, they have the Freya, they have the Osiris online, and once those guys start to get online with the Kepri, it's going to be hard to stop them. Yannis chunks late game as well. He's going to out-chunk that Hades, unless Hades is kind of one and done, and apparently there's a glitch because I see 13 stacks on Yubs' Warlock Sash there now.
Oh, I actually, you know what that might be? Yubs did disconnect. That's the reason for this pause.
So, okay, I didn't even notice.
Yeah, so maybe his disconnect is what caused the Warlock Sash stacks to actually fall on and off. Maybe that means he just reconnected and we will be out of the pause soon.
Yeah, hopefully so. The other interesting thing to note here as well, Rich, look at Mail Renewal on Guan Yu. Guan Yu has melee renewal. Smart pickup by him to first build that. He knows he's been a part of a lot of team fights there. Gives him some cooldown reduction. He's been a part of 5 different deaths. Has no deaths there, and he'll be able to get in there and just sustain for these team fights if the melee renewal procs on an assist or kill. Banish and a root almost connecting on him. However, there in the dual lane, that could have spelled imminent death for him.
Yeah, that was a pretty strong harass there. They did manage to push him off, but like you said, just didn't connect those abilities, and Guan Yu's going to stay in this lane and make light work of these minions.
The interesting thing to note there is Freya. Okay, Bronze, just coming with that Xbox controller, just getting used to it. But that banish, really hard to hit. I don't know if you've ever seen what Freya's banish is like, but the hitbox,
small. It is. That's why you don't see Freya played too often. Freya's right up there with Uller as to impossible skill shots. I would actually say Freya's harder than Uller.
Freya's interesting. Freya's actually a fairly popular, has been a fairly popular pick for this level of play. But the issue, obviously, is that she's fallen off in favor of Medusa and X-Ball here lately and Rama. On the Xbox.
Medusa's just like such a huge pick right now. You just see Medusa picked absolutely all the time.
We're going to see Yubs taking a lot of damage here. His 3-man rotation comes on him in the side lane. X-Ball and Freya dueling it out down here. Not trading a whole lot, actually, as Freya pops for one, looking to put some damage on top of Caruxes. He tries to clear himself from under tower.
Yeah, he's just trying to make sure he gets all the experience from that wave, though. Doesn't want to lose any of it to the tower. We might see another rotation actually coming in on the mid right now.
I think what we're seeing happen here is XGN's looking to bait something. They're looking to bait tower dive. Here we go. We're going to see the fight on the mid lane. Here comes the Ares ult. The cats are going to be dropped down, and Blackside taking a lot of damage here. He's going to pop the flamethrower as well. Mace the Face going to pick up that kill with the unstable vortex.
I'm really surprised Mace managed to pull that one out of the bag. It looked like it was just a really strong engage where they managed to do a lot of damage. It looked like Aware was going to manage to sneak away from it, though, without losing any life, and they did lose one. Mace found a way to get it.
Yeah, Mace able just to skin, just getting that by the skin of his teeth there, as a lot of damage come out by Bastet. We talked about this earlier. Bastet kind of shreds tanks earlier. She gets ahead, she continues to do it for the rest of the game, and she'll continue to death Ares every time he goes up that ultimate. Just drop those cats. Proxy really low here. Look for a potential tower dive.
Yeah, we saw it start, and then we saw him back off, and Cruxy is just going to have to recall right now, and that's going to leave the duo lane wide open.
Yeah, duo lane is wide open here right now. We may see a lot of damage go down here on the tier 1. No teleport, obviously, going to be picked up by a carry. So Cruxy may be a little bit far behind as Ares makes the rotation with some wave clear, but not much.
Yeah, he's got to get to lane here, but it does not look like they're going to be able to put any pressure onto that tier 1, which is something they definitely want to do by this point in the game, especially with the way that XGN does play. XGN usually wants to put some sort of pressure on the map, probably before the 18-minute mark, and I think this comp has just kind of locked them down, and they haven't really been able to do it. They are going to go into their own camp right now, take the attack speed buff for Freya now that she's left, and they might actually go in here and open up with a team fight.
Yeah, we see Freya on the chase here right now. Guan Yu looking to zone them off of the Gold Fury. He's just stepping up here now. Bastet making the rotation here as well. Homie eyeing on T-Smalls. T-Smalls going to back it off here now as well.
Yeah, nothing too surprising there, but the Gold Fury is definitely the place to look right now. Someone needs to get it right now.
We're almost past Gold Fury time.
Yeah, if it's going to happen, it's going to happen now. But
Once we pass 20 minutes, you're in Fire Giant territory.
Yeah, Bastet looking like she's going to actually try to initiate here. The Shibalanka ult is going to go off, and we might actually see a few kills go down right here. Here we go. Blackseye down.
Blackseye just getting targeted by this cats all game long. T-Small already down to half health. Yubs with an excellent Pillar of Agni to sustain that kill for Freya.
But yeah, we are going to see a trade there. It's 7-7 with 19 minutes on the clock. Looks like this game is an absolute gridlock.
Yeah, it is so far. I mean, it is very close. I mean,
here
the only
is that
place anyone's taking a lead is in the XP difference, and we're going to see the big fight going to happen here on Gold Fury as we see the showdown in the middle of the small western town here on the left-hand side of the map.
Yeah, it looks like they backed off of that Gold Fury really fast. No one really came in. I think they were looking more for a team fight than anything else. Mace of the Face going to try to position himself back around this tower, meeting up with Osiris. Looks like they're a little scared to open up here. No one wants to make that mistake because they're just so even. If a mistake comes in, it could just absolutely cost them the game.
See, this is the thing that happens. You can actually throw a game being too cautious if you aren't taking the opportunities that are being handed to you. When you get to the point where you're becoming complacent and you just want to bait out to late game, you end up throwing the game. You lose the little opportunities that could have made you win. Aware needs to be careful of not engaging while ultimates are down. They know that Bastet's ultimate has been down for the last little while. Cat's obviously up now, but they kind of blew that opportunity where they could have got Ares in for a hard engage.
Yeah, it does look like Sun Wukong has managed to get a little bit of an XP gain up on Osiris. They're going to box a little bit here. Curious to see what comes out of it. Wukong does manage to get the stun off on him. We are seeing Osiris take a lot of damage here. He's going to have to back off just a little bit.
Wukong has been winning out these engagements. If you look at the gold between these two characters, 9,900 on the side of Wukong.
Here's a big ult mid right now. Are you seeing this? We're going to actually see the dive from Bastet take down Blacksai again. This is the second time he's gone down in like 2 minutes.
Look at that two-man stun from T-Small, though, on the horse as the root is popped down and misses on top of Guan Yu. Conviction can be popped. Here's the Pillar Agony. The pounce is going to be real with the escape from the portal as well with Bastet as Proxy gets soloed in his own jungle.
XGN starting to show their experience. They're going to continue pushing pressure onto Yubs. It doesn't look like this tower dive is going to pay off, though. We might see Bastet go down. Yeah, there's Bastet.
A slick conviction from Guan Yu there to get the heal on Yubs. Yubs was gonna die. Yubs with the Bluestone proc and the bleed from Bastet after stepping in our tower, he was dead. He was dead meat. He had no ability to heal. He had no mini waves around. That was a big deal.
Yeah, T-Small really, really showing what Guan Yu can do and gonna continue to push this mid lane right now. This mid lane has been in an absolute stalemate though. There's a little bit more structure damage done to Aware's tower. But at the end of the day, the mid lane has been pretty locked up as well.
Aware is slightly winning in the tower department right now as Sun Wukong is starting to body Osiris just a little bit. He has the Mystical Mail online, Mailer Renewal. He didn't even bother building into Jotun's Wrath as the Mystical Mail damage he's hoping is just enough. Osiris doing the same with a Frostbound Hammer to try and lock down the Sun Wukong, obviously with the bird form, able to escape fairly easily from the tether.
Yeah, we're going to see an engagement right here in the mid lane. Once again, the ultimate is coming out.
And no Bastet in sight this time as we see Mace of the Face taking a whole lot of damage. He's just going to portal on out of there. There's no further lockdown. Sun Wukong getting chased down by Osiris as well here.
Yeah, Sun Wukong actually going to use his beast to get out of there. Moving back over to Shibalanka. Taking a lot of damage. Freya might be able to get this hill. Yeah, and we're going to see Mace of the Face read that really well and jump right in there and pick off the kill. Guan Yu is going to try to finish off Mace of the Face, though, and Mace is going to use his portal to get right out. Jonas is such a strong god.
His rotations are a strong part. The nice thing to note there, did you see the ultimate come through?
Yeah, I did.
Proxy was already low. It smashed Proxy in the face. He was going to go down regardless. But just comboing that, even if Cruxy was half health there, he probably would have been one shot with the Giannis, as he did have the bonus there with just coming through a portal.
Yeah, that was really strong play by Mace of the Face. We're actually going to see Guan Yu rotate back. He's going to try to pick up this Osiris kill here, and I would be surprised if he didn't get it. Here it is. There, if Sun Wukong's going to get the actual kill, but they make light work.
Mystical Mail actually going to pick up that kill from Sun Wukong, actually. He was stunned out and tether there, and he actually picked up that kill with the Mystical Mail tick.
Well, that is absolutely beautiful.
Yeah, I know. You love seeing stuff like that. I bet Guan Yu's cursing on him right now. At least he has Mail Renewal proc, I guess.
Toby, that's pretty big right now. They're slightly behind. We're slightly behind.
Yeah, they are slightly behind, and that's going to happen with Cruxy getting outboxed a little bit right now. Cruxy should be theoretically outboxing the Freya right now. He's going to be portaled, and the beads are going to be popped. He's going to have to jump on out of there as Guan Yu makes the rotation. Five man on the side there for Aware in the left-hand side of the jungle.
Yeah, XGN just looking, starting to look scary. They're starting to look confident, and they're starting to look scary.
They are. I think this is where XGN really might take the cake in these types of matches. Here's Ares, however, with the chains going to go down, but Freya is level 19. Here's the through space and time coming in with the hot rotation from XGN. Candyman being boxed into a corner here. He is body blocked hard. Mace the Face going to portal on out of there. There's the Ares ult. Cat going to be dropped as well on Ares as he's looking like in a lot of trouble. T-Small here on the back line against Freya. Homie going to pick up the kill with those cats on the back.
Guan Yu was looking so strong, and then he goes down, and we're going to see a few more deaths here, surely. We're going to see Sun Wukong pick one up on Bastet, and it is not done yet. We are going to see Hades go down here, too. I think Hades is going to go down yet. Jonas is going to throw him up in the air. Sun Wukong is going... Wow, that's a double kill.
That is huge by Candyman. There are a lot of sick plays. We're going to see the ultimate from Sun Wukong. If he lands on anyone here, Bluestone Proc is going to hit Mace to the Face as well. Look for Candyman. He's going to target our minion. There is the cudgel as well. And going to put Mace to the Face down. He's going to be pushed out as Cruxy makes the move up. He's going to be subdued by the Kefri, but his auto attacks can still take there as Cruxy makes the lead under tower.
Cruxy with the triple kill.
On Giannis as well.
Cruxy gets the triple kill, manages to finish off all the work that Sun Wukong puts in, and then Sun Wukong just walks right up to the tower, and he's going to try to take this down.
And that's a big turn there for Aware. You're going to see the gold lead go firmly in their hand here after this tier 1 tower goes down. About 1,000 gold you're going to see in favor of them. Or maybe about 500.
Yeah, it's 600 right now. XP difference still there, but definitely diminishing and moving back into the favor of Aware.
The cats being dropped so early there. Yeah, I picked up the kill on the Ares. But the issue that came about after that is that Bastet's kit was extended, and you've seen Yubs come in with that awesome Pillar of Agony. The nice thing to note here, he grabbed two people with that, and he did take two people down there, but Kefri able to time that ult perfectly and actually saved a death there, at least kept his team into the fight.
Yeah, Sun Wukong managed to bully Bastet a little bit while they took down the Gold Fury, and now Bastet's just trying to get away without dying, but Guan Yu is going to be able to get in there and finish it off, but the fight is not over. Guan Yu is still messing around, but he gets up on his horse and runs away.
Yeah, he's going to use that for the escape there. Keep it nice and chill after that win. They're going to get the Gold Fury. They're going to get the tower. They're going to get the kill on Bastet as well there. And that, ladies and gentlemen, has put Aware a 3,000 gold lead at this point in the game. And they've actually still haven't taken back the XP lead.
Yeah, XGN2 right now, they know that they need to come up with some sort of play to put Aware Gaming back in their place. And we are going to see Kepri putting on a little bit of pressure here. Jonas, Mace is just going to try to move in right now. I'm not sure if he's going to be able to put in enough pressure. This might be an overextend.
Some time, just hit three men there, Rich, on their way to escape. And Kepri going to come in behind tower. They're going to take a lot of damage as Candyman makes his way in. He is the team right now. He is the front line.
Yeah, Candyman already being at level 20.
Interesting thing to note here is that the Pillar of Agni is down. A lot of ultimates on the down on the side of Aware. Key ultimates. You know, a lot of that team fight set up. The ultimate from Ares down. The ultimate from Hades down. You still have the cast from Bastet up. The Freya ult down. And the Kefri ult. So if XGN wanted to start a fight here in the next few minutes.
Yeah.
Or next 30 seconds, I should say.
That would probably be a very good time for them to initiate the fight. But where do you think they do it? Where do you think they strike if they try to initiate a team fight right now?
Yubs has been pushing up in his lane a little bit too much. And you've seen it just there. He just was poked down about half health. If they're going to initiate somewhere, that's where it'll be on top of Yubs.
Yeah, so we might see that in the next 30 seconds, but the time is definitely running out for them. Ultimate's coming back online for Aware Gaming, slowly but surely.
We see that Ares ult back online already, and that's a key contributor to their teamfight success. Ares still level 14 and Kepri's level 17. That continues to be the story. Kepri is just so tanky right now, and Ares is getting bursted down in fights by the Bastet cats. With that level advantage, level 19 on Bastet, level 19 cats going on that level 14. Ares is just ripping him to shreds.
Yeah, it is definitely looking pretty lethal every time we do see it. Right now, though, it's definitely not out of the reach for XGN. Like you said, looking at the graphs, they still slightly hold an XP gain. Oh, this is that XGN teamfight that we wanted to see. Ares is going up, popping his ultimate, but he's going to go down to Freya, and it's not even going to be hard. They're still looking very healthy. Guan Yu's going to have to back away here. He moves to the damage camp, helps out Hades, but XGN's got to be happy with themselves right now.
Yeah, and Aware knows that they need to back off after that fight. Ares getting a little bit too aggressive. They're getting pulled by the Kefri once again and using the ultimate to try and get at least some CC immunity. But by that point, Guan Yu came in with conviction to heal him up, but it just wasn't enough.
Yeah, and XGN's going to manage to take this tower too, just polish it off really quick. They're
first
still looking really strong.
Look at Candyman. He's in deep trouble here right now. If he's not careful, you better hope that bird form is put in the right direction as he's still engaging here on Bobby as Bastet comes in as well as the Giannis, and he's going to bird form out of there, and that probably could have been prevented with a nice portal from the Giannis.
Yeah, he's lucky that he managed to get out of there with that bird form.
Looking at Freya.
Looking at Freya right now.
Here comes the horse, and Cruxy horse is amazing. Going to take down DJ Bronxy.
Couldn't even get there quick enough. Cruxy managed to take down Freya.
Yeah, it's absolutely crazy. I think that might have been a poison dart tick after the damage. Probably the last tick on poison darts. That we probably seen before we actually went to go watch that fight and picked up that kill. Or maybe it was Bluestone. Could be either, really.
Yeah,
we see mid-camps going as well.
Yeah, we did just see the mid-camps go down. This is one of those matches where we're not going to be able to tell who's going to win for at least another 5-10 minutes. This is just going back and forth. Both teams looking so good. My confidence in Aware Gaming has definitely just increased.
And this is a problem that Aware's had for a long time. They kind of have those hot and cold games when it comes to picks and bans. And I say it a lot, and it's not to harp on these guys, but they're so skilled. They really are. I wouldn't be able to play at their level. That's the truth. But they do get hot and cold when it comes to their picks and bans. And you can tell that this game is a hot game for them on their picks, and last game was definitely cold.
Do they have a coach or anything, or are they one of those teams that doesn't have one?
Mystix was their coach. Mystix used to play for Disney Accelerate or Disney Acceleration. I can't remember their name. Yeah. They were involved in the whole thing with the five angry men way back last year in the Challengers Cup. So Mystix used to be that coach, but I think during this whole denial Aware shakeup thing, I don't think he's – I think he no longer coaches Aware right now. So okay. I'm not sure if they do have a coach right now.
Okay. So that would definitely help in the picks bans department.
Yeah, for sure. And I mean, if you could pick up someone who has some high level SPL experience that is knowledgeable, okay, that's the key point there. As long as you just pick up an SPL player.
Yeah.
Because just because you play SPL doesn't mean you have that huge picks and bans knowledge or the game knowledge. If you pick someone up like that's maybe out on the pro scene, like a lot of European teams have, like Confrey, Proxy, QQ, and SunTouch have all gone over former SPL players. And have gone over to coach European teams right now in the Xbox scene. If they pick someone up like that, it might be beneficial.
Yeah, looking right now, Guan Yu is going to open up right now onto Osiris, and Hades is going to help support it, and Shibalaka is going to push in this damage and try to get him down. Will they be able to do it, though? Osiris managing to kind of walk away and disengage. He does get his little jump here, and we're going to see the rest of XGN rotate in and manage to push in quite a bit of damage, but not enough to scare off Aware all the way. Guan Yu is still moving. Looks like they're going to move back right now to the Gold Fury.
We're going to see a little bit of musical chairs here. We're going to see Aware actually get on that Gold Fury here now, but XGN knows what's going to happen here. They aren't anybody's fools. As Blackside going to step up here, but he needs to be careful. He is only level 15. Here is the ultimate. He is going to pop beads on the Freya, plus the ultimate is going to come out as well. She tries to put some damage down on Blackside. Blackside a lot more tankier than the last team fight. We're seeing Bronxy shred up here now as this makes a move up there. Blackside finally going to pick up the kill. Kepri ult expended on the Honest. That was a misclick here. The Pillar of Agni as well, Rich. That's going to shred both of those tanks as Osiris is getting melted out here. Now there's the Tiger Sun to secure that kill as well.
First, I really thought XGN was going to be at an advantage in that fight, doing the invade themselves, but looks like they just got cut down the size by Aware Gaming, and they're going to go back to the Gold Fury and try to secure it, while Sun Wukong just kind of boxes Kepri and keeps him completely out of the way.
Yeah, Sun Wukong is incredibly tanky here right now. He's only now building into his penetration. He's built three items right now that have made him extremely tanky. You see the Mystical Mail online, the Mail and Renewal, and we see the shield as well. So, I mean, that's a big, big tanky Sun Wukong right now, and he does a lot of damage just from that Mystical Mail.
Mace came in with a cheeky little play there. He managed to bounce all over the place and did reset the Gold Fury once, but it just wasn't enough. Aware Gaming does manage to take it down. That is their third Gold Fury of the game.
4,500. Oh my god, I forgot to turn my cell phone off before. I'm fired.
I was like, wait, was that mine? I went to look at it really quick.
Yeah, no, that's classic Ravage. Classic Ravage. Looking at gold, though, Rich, we're going to see 4,600 gold in favor of Aware right now. That's getting steep. You're not at the point of no return yet. I mean, you're about 5,000 gold off from that. But the thing we need to know here is that once everyone gets to level 20, the gold is starting to get thinner. The gold means less and less,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
They're going to get full item bills, and then it just comes down to team fights.
Yeah, because at that point in the game, it's the time spent in the graveyard that is the most valuable or scariest resource, right?
Yeah, and we're going to see, then it comes into a game of just buff control in your own camp, ward control, fire giant control, just lane pressure, and it becomes a much more tactical game at that point because there's less things to focus on. You're not focusing just on laning phase anymore. You're into the point of the game where, hey, everyone's level 20, we're full build, it's time to just get tactical. Lane pressure, objectives. Cruxy in trouble here now as he gets a four-man rotation.
Yeah, he does manage to save himself a little bit with his ultimate. Kefri's going to kind of keep pressure on, but Jonas dropping the portal to get Kepri out. Very easy escape for him there. We are going to see both teams now moving into this duo lane. We may see some blood here.
Candyman almost went down there. Very close. Pop that ultimate at the right time. Almost too late there. We're going to see Bronxy taking a lot of damage. Kepri all going to go down to him. They're going to have to change their targets and just look to push the minion wave here. No sustain this fight for XGN.
Aware Gaming just looking so dominant right now. Kepri's gonna shoot through his son. The cudgel goes up in the air, but it's not enough.
It's not enough there. The Ares ult as well gonna get in there, but we're gonna see the percentage damage shred from Ares there with the Pillar of Agony. Homie gonna pick up the kill there, and Cruxy gonna pick up the other on the Osiris. That was a good trade there. Cruxy in a little bit too deep here, and they need to be careful as they back off here, as XGN could take a tower.
Who does that trade favor?
That trade is really a wash unless something come out of it in regards to a global objective. There's no Gulf here on this side of the map. There's no lanes pushing into secure tower right now. The only way this trades in favor of XGN is if they take this tower, which they probably won't with the amount of push that they have here.
They're definitely trying to, and they're pushing pressure into Cruxy too to try to get him to back off. And they're definitely, there we go. The tower does go down.
Yeah, that tower will go down. I'll leave my words.
That's what XGN likes to do, too. XGN really does like to get in there and just kind of put pressure on the map.
That's their strength. Their strength is these team fights, and that's what they've shown us. Their knowledge of team fights and their strategy has been their strength in these games. And they showed it right there. Just good patience by them. Good ability to get Cruxy separated from the rest of his team under tower there, and that was enough to push them off.
Yeah, we're seeing everyone pretty much go back right now. Are we seeing any big items come online that may shift the tide of these team fights?
Not really. I mean, we're seeing an interesting build coming out here from the Ares thus far. You see that Pestilence obviously put on the board for the Freya for her innate lifesteal built into her kit. And the Midgardian's Mail, which is obviously to counter Freya as well, to create some space between her and Osiris when they're auto-attacking. This slows them with every attack. So that kind of blocks out Freya's passive on her one.
XGN getting so aggressive right now. The Shiva Laka all just was popped, but we're going to see Yubs go down easily to Bastet, and the fight's not over yet. We're going to see Guan Yu get up on that horse and just try to run away. There's nothing else that he can do there. Yeah.
Cruxy taking a lot of damage, and he is going to jump the wrong way. He barely escaped. They're just dodging the Spirit Flail. Osiris on the chase on her tower. Cruxy going to go down.
Does manage to get it.
See the pull on Candyman.
Freya barely gets away there, too. Freya had almost no life left at all.
Absolutely insane. That could have went any way there. Guan Yu getting forced out nice and early out of that team fight.
That really kind of showed the strength of XGN.
Yeah, XGN definitely was able to just cut off the enemy team. Osiris going deep under the tower there, and actually with his life gonna keep up there. They're looking to bait the fire giant here by the looks of things. Just getting Kepri to start attacking that to make it look like it's going in. It's going to be successful. They're going to get three men of aware in against four as we see the Talos Assault go down. And here comes Bronx back into the fight here now. Not a whole lot of damage traded just yet, but that can change real quick as T-Small is going to have to use that horse once again to get out the through space and time, trying to secure that kill. It's not going to get the Guan Yu, but they will be able to pick up Blackside here as he's being forced into the blue belt camp. Candyman also on the run there, finally going to fall to Mace of the Face, and Bronx can pick up the kill on Candyman.
And those two kills, so important here. They're going to rotate right over to the Fire Giant right now, and if they get their whole team Fire Giant, they might be able to push an objective before they even have to back. They're looking pretty healthy right now. The only person who is at half health is Osiris, and now they all have the Fire Giant buff.
Yeah, Hades is a little bit late there. He does have the potential to steal on Fire Giant, but this Fire Giant buff is going to sustain them. If they can get one pick here, they will be able to push right down into the middle lane, which they will. Yub's going to get taken down there with the burst. They'll be able to take down the middle lane or the right solo tier 1, which is what they're going to opt to do here. They may be able to get the tier 2 here as well if they play it right.
Yeah, that tier 1 was so easy for them to take down. It falls right now. They're going to march right on forward to the tier 2, and there's no reason that they shouldn't. The only person there to contest it is Guan Yu. He is backed by Shiva Laka, but Shiva Laka knows that he needs to kind of back off a little too scary.
Yeah, Cat's going to be dropped there. They're not going to wait for the minion wave. They're just going to burst that down, go back by, and then they're going to group up, likely for the push straight down mid lane.
Right now, if you're aware gaming, how do you get into lane? Where do you go on the map to kind of counteract the pressure that you know XGN's about to put on?
You've got a turtle right now. You've got a turtle under that. You gotta make sure that mid wave continually push up. They need to make sure now while they've gone back, Candyman is going clear up the solo lane, so that's not an issue. Someone going in for the split push on the Phoenix. You need to make sure you ward up your jungle, especially on the right side, because Bastet can easily come in with Cats. Her cooldown reduction is very, very high right now at this point. She has the Mail of Renewal and the Jotuns online. And with all that stuff online, I mean, she can come in, pop those Cats, and maybe melt that tower.
Yeah.
A Phoenix.
We just saw XGN right now just kind of move through, take all the camps that they know they needed to take, and now they're actually moving over to the Gold Fury.
Yeah, we're getting into the full item builds here right now, so it's more about just clearing the jungle camps, getting ready for that big push down middle lane. XGN has to be careful about wasting the Fire Giant buff here. They need to make sure they go in. They put a big push on one of the lanes and just use that to their advantage. So they need to group up here.
Yeah, and securing that Gold Fury too, that's more of, it's less of we need the Gold Fury than we want Aware to not get the Gold Fury. They want to shut down objectives so they cannot come back into this game. And now we're going to see them push right into this tier 2 tower.
Yeah, and this is what we need to see. That's one of the most valuable towers on the map right now, as the dual lane is the hardest to push. We're going to see the big grouping from Aware under Tower. Sire is going to opt to go and try and solo that tier 2 in the middle lane as well. So all Phoenixes will be exposed here. Going to be opening up for the Bastet split push if they want it. Brawler's beat online with the Jotuns. Not terrible for being able to take a tower right now.
Yeah, they're looking really strong, and the curious thing, though, is they do need to be careful, because if Aware opens up with a really strong team fight, this is looking kind of scary.
Yeah, Candyman almost found himself caught in a bad position there. There's the Tigers going to come out there as well, and the Cat's going to be on top of Candyman. Candyman going to have to ult on out of that one. Cat's going to be down. Middle Phoenix is likely going to be taken here, and not likely, it's a certainty. Yelp's going to come in here with the Pillar of Agni. Yanish just barely going to escape there. Age is going to be popped as well as Capriol for that, as we see Cruxy on the chase with Blackside. Has that cripple on top of the Capriol. Beads are going to be popped to get out of it.
Yeah, they took down the Phoenix, but they definitely are paying the cost right now. We might see a few people go down here. Cruxy is going to manage to polish off Freya. Kepri and Jonas trying to run back.
Aware needs to be relentless here. They need to make sure that they dive on this and they pick up one of these kills here, and they continue to push down center. We're going to see Bastet, however, making the rotation. She sees the minion wave is pushed up. No one back to defend. She's going to be able to pick up this left Phoenix if no one gets back. Conviction going to be popped from the Guan Yu to sustain on this mid tower, but they don't have the damage to pick up a big tank like Osiris right now.
Yeah, this Bastet push could be huge. You can see the Phoenix going down. It's about to fall. There it is.
Yeah, and we're going to see the Phoenix go down here. If Aware can make something out of this, it may not be a complete wash, but as it looks right now, they have a minions pushing in on their Titan, and they need to be careful because they could lose the third Phoenix, as we see Giannis Mosaris making the rotation.
Yeah, we do see them moving in right now. This is looking pretty good for XGN. What do they have to do to secure the win, though? I guess they just have to keep the pressure onto the Phoenix. Guan Yu is going to try to get in there and disrupt it at least a little bit.
Yeah, we're seeing that pressure put on the right Phoenix here still, as Giannis almost found himself in a real bad situation there. He's going to have to ult on out of there as well as the portal, and that is worth his life. At this point in the game, you don't want to give up anything.
Yeah, we've seen Baze get into a lot of positions like that. He's managed to get just into the last breath of his life and get out.
Yeah, he's been able to just sneak on out of there all game long. The interesting thing is that this reminds me a lot of a game. I saw a game that looked just like this a couple months ago versus Juice and Mortality, the old Mortality NA roster, where they had two Phoenixes taken down. They were just started bodying the other team, and they had a similar comp to this. Juice did, and they actually managed to come back and win it to actually secure their three Phoenixes eventually. This is a very long game, and we're getting to the point where we're approaching that 60-minute mark. We're about 17 minutes away.
Yeah.
And I can't help but think that that might be this type of game right now.
I can see that happening,
too. It's really closing anyone out.
Yeah, now we're going to see a little bit of a fight going down right near the Fire Giant. Someone might actually turn the Fire Giant on if they're not careful. We're going to see Guan Yu go up on the Cavalry, and he's going to try to push in, but he does not get enough damage onto XGN. They're going to manage to back away with their lives, and they're going to try to push into Sun Wukong, but just not enough damage to be had.
Excellent job there timing the Aegis with the Capri ult for Freya to get out of this gate. They actually had to turn away from that, as all they were going to do is reset Freya to about half health and she'd be able to get back in the fight. Candyman actually going to be a victim of Capri there with the honest rotation, as we're looking at the Ares ult coming out here as well. Grab from Capri.
XGN just being absolutely relentless, and right now we're actually seeing the Order Titan take quite a bit of damage. It's already down at 70%. We're seeing people back right now. They need to get those minions off of their Titan. And there we go. There's a kill on Cruxy. This is big. This is their time to push. They may be able to close this out right now.
Yeah, this is likely game here. You have your Order Titan at 65%. You just lost a key member of your team in Cruxy. He's been putting a lot of damage on the board. If you look at the charts right now, he's second in damage in the game. Second only to Giannis. 40,000 damage on the board.
There's the Titan.
Yeah, Titan is going to go down here. That's going to be a two-game set for XGN. And they just showed that they are just strong in team fights.
Yeah, so, I mean, early on, it really looked like it was favoring Aware. What do you think turned it around for XGN there?
The thing that turned around from XGN is just they had patience and they won key objective battles. They managed to split up Aware's team on a number of occasions. They managed to separate Cruxy from the rest of his team and isolate him. They managed to catch Yubs out in a couple of occasions, and Yubs was a big part of their team fight. The other thing that really crippled Aware was how far behind Blacksky was. He was getting outfarmed fairly severely by the enemy Capri. And that has a lot to do with Capri's ability to clear waves. Capri can go to a lane and he can clear out an entire wave. So, you know, that becomes a problem as well.
Yeah, I mean, looking now that we've seen both these teams play more games, XGN is proving to be somewhat of a force. I'm very interested to see them go up against some of the teams like Elevate, Juice, and those matches are coming up very soon. How do you think they'll fare?
It'll be interesting. I mean, Aware hasn't really proven that they are going to come in and they're going to body any of those big teams. You know, they've shown they can compete, but they haven't shown they can body. And XGN really didn't. They kind of scraped by Aware, to be completely honest.
Yeah, it seemed like they were going to lose at quite a few moments, but then we saw just incredible coordination from the teams, which just does hint at something.
Yeah, it hints at something. They have something going there, and I think once Aware gets some of their stuff together, gets together some of the blips with the new roster, maybe it'll be a stronger roster. I'm not sure. It's either that or XGN just hasn't reached the level on Xbox just yet, because this should have been a game that I think a former SPL team over the Aware team probably should have took a two-game set.
Yeah, and I think that XGN, really, they kind of lucked out with the matches that they've had in front of them so far, and now moving into some of the more difficult matches that they will have, they kind of have more time to adapt to the Xbox, so we may see them actually shine and see their full potential.
Yeah, and I believe it was Onslaught, it was the original XGN roster, so that's a 0-2 for this XGN. Who was the other team, Rich?
Who was the other team who has...
That XGN faced. Do you recall?
I'm trying to remember the team that they managed to split with. I think it was Release. They split with Release.
Okay, well, Release is a really good split to have on your resume.
That definitely is.
That's a top team for sure.
Yeah, Release is a very strong team. And like you said, it's kind of funny because it is Xing's team. And Xing used to be on the Denial team. So they definitely do know how Xing plays.
Yeah, no, that's for sure. They're definitely aware of Xing's strengths and weaknesses. So yeah, I bet that was an interesting one. I actually missed that one. So
yeah,
I'm sad.
Well,
I didn't realize
the VOD is up. I put the VOD up today. So
okay, I'll have to go back and watch it.
Yeah, it's actually time for me to say goodbye. Ravage, it was so much fun having you. If you're around, I would love to see you tomorrow at 6:00.
All right, sounds good. I'll be around.
And so it was. So it's time to say goodbye. Ravage, I will see you tomorrow. We'll do two more matches then. And from the MLG studios, gonna wrap up the night. Like I said, 6:00 tomorrow, we are going to have two more matches. I will tweet that out. You can follow me and Ravage on Twitter. We'll be talking about it all night. Thank you so much for coming. Until tomorrow, good night.